Let's dig into some of the details of the DHT technology. The first namespace that the DHT technology has to deal with is the Keyspace namespace. So the way namespace is managed is if you have content to disseminate, you generate a unique key for that content by using some algorithm like SHA-1, which generates a 160-bit key. The number of bits in the key or the signature is big enough that there will not be collision even if different content are using the same algorithm to generate this key. So that is how you create a unique signature for a particular content using SHA-1. The second namespace we have to deal with is a node space. So here, what we are doing is we are creating an SHA-1 hash of IP addresses of nodes that want to share content. So let's say that me and my buddies form a social network, and all our IP addresses, we're going to use this algorithm to encode them into this 160-bit node ID. So now we've got two namespaces. One is the Keyspace namespace and the NodeSpace namespace, and both of them are derived using the same algorithmic technique, let's say. So in this case, we have created a key for the content so that there's a unique signature for a particular content. Similarly, we have created a node ID from the IP address, which is again a unique signature for a particular IP address. The objective is if I have a key, I want to store that key in a node ID N such that the key is very close to the node ID N. Ideally, if you're lucky, the key is exactly equal to N, but you know, it's not possible to guarantee that this hash and this hash will result in exactly the same value so long as it is close enough. Like in the previous example, I showed you that if I generated a hash 149, I stored it in a node 150, which is close enough to the hash that I created. So the API for manipulating this distributed hash table data structure would be put key and get key. So put key will take two arguments, the key and the value. Value can be anything that you want to associate with that. In the previous example, I said the value may be the IP address of the content that is associated with that particular key. And get key takes one argument, namely the key, and returns the value that is associated with that key value pair.